Isn't it great to have a 12:15 Mass on Sunday? We can all stay in bed a lot longer in the morning. When I have the early Mass, I have to get up at 6:45. I get tempted by our common enemy, the devil. Why don't you phone in and pretend to be sick and you can stay in bed? And I think, oh, that, yeah. And then I think of hundreds of people here in church and I tell the devil where to go and what to do with his temptations. But it's nice to have the 12:15 too. Well, today we're celebrating the baptism of our Lord. And that day, some 2,000 years ago, when Christ, by his baptism in the River Jordan, began his public preaching of salvation for all people, is a day that no Christian can ever forget. The baptism of John was for sinners, a sign of a change of heart and a turning to God. Well, Jesus never sinned. He never turned away from God. He was God. But he was the representative of sinful humanity. And that day he represented us sinners. And he opened the door of salvation for all of us. And in that ceremony, on that occasion, Christ was proclaimed by his heavenly Father to be his Son and to be a faithful servant. And the power of the Holy Spirit came upon him, as the Scripture tells us. Well, as God, Jesus already had all of the things in common with the Father and the Holy Spirit, but in his human nature, our weak, sinful human nature, Jesus on that day proclaimed God's true and faithful servant. At the same moment, he represented us human beings. He became one like us, born of a mother, to be like us and to be our representatives and to expiate all of our sins. We at that time were made God's adopted children, and the mission of Christ was for us. The incarnation took place because of God's infinite love for us, and he wanted mankind, humankind, the antithesis of his creation, his best creation of all, to be united with the divine, united the human with the divine, and gave us the opportunity and the invitation to spend an eternity of happiness with God in heaven. So that's certainly something special to be thankful for. So how could a Christian who knows all this ever refuse to do the little part that we are all called upon to do, to reverence and respect God, and to do what is right? And reverence and respect for God should come easy for us when we think of what God went through, what Jesus suffered for us, willingly, didn't have to, but did it out of love for us. And we are asked to strive to keep the laws that God has given us. We human beings are weak. We have all failed in small or large ways in various times. But the merciful, compassionate God, thankfully, is not like us human beings who are not too ready to forgive. And God's mercy and understanding are not finite or limited like us human beings. And God's love is for sinners as well as saints, provided that the sinner repents and comes to the Lord and asks for forgiveness and seeks to be a better person. And of course, we're doing that many times before you and I get to be 100 years of age. There'll be many more times we'll use that wonderful gift of the sacrament of reconciliation, say, it's me again. I need forgiveness for whatever it happens to be. We all have our weak sins. Some of us are proud, some of us think we're better than others, and some are uncharitable, and some are mean, and we human beings, we do dumb, stupid, crazy things at times. We don't even know why we sin. Our mouth lets us down so frequently. We say something and immediately, why did I say that? Why did I treat that person so badly? So there'll be many, many times in life we'll be asking the Lord for his love and for his forgiveness. So the commemoration of the Lord's baptism in the River Jordan is for us today one of the loving calls of Christ. He wants us to be less ungrateful, more appreciative for all that he has done for us. And he wants us to see this life for what it is, a short journey, 60, 70, 80, some reach 90, and boy, do we have a party if someone reaches 100, and then there's an eternity, and hopefully we will spend an eternity with God in heaven. So Christ suffered to win this life for us, and when we think of what he's done for us and the reward that he is offering us and wants us to have, our worldly trials and tribulations, we look at them as mere trivialities compared to what the Lord offers us, an eternity of happiness in heaven. That Jesus insisted on being baptized in the River Jordan is, like all the other sinful human beings, is another sign and proof of his love for us. He would undergo any humiliation. We know we're sinners, but if I pointed somebody in the congregation and said, "You are a sinner," they would, "How dare you? I'm going to complain to the bishop. You insulted me." And yet the truth is we are, every one of us, sinners in God's eyes. But we don't like being told that. And certainly you wouldn't like the priest in the pulpit to say, "Look, everybody, this person, that person's a sinner." Jesus took all that humiliation and was baptized like all the human sinners of all different kinds that were baptized in the River Jordan. And by this act of self-humiliation, he began his messianic mission of salvation for all people and for all sinners, including you and including me. Do I hear an amen? Amen. Worried there for a while. Let's stand now and make our profession of faith as we recite our creed.